Morning, church. My sermon today is titled, What Are You Taking Home? You know, when we come to church, we have so many things that we want to take with us from here. And I don't know what you are going to take, but ask yourself, what are you taking home? And before we do that, can we just bow our heads? Our Heavenly Father, we invite you to come and be with us. And may you cover us with your blood as we are now feeding into the bread of life. And stay with us and bless us. And when we have been blessed, may we depart to save. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. What are you taking home? Right, my sermon today will be based on a story of little Zacchaeus. I think we all know the story of little Zacchaeus. And if we have all our Bibles, let's hold them on to chapter 19 of Luke. Luke chapter 19. We'll be reading from chapter 10. Luke 19 from verse 1 to 10. Luke 19 verse 1 to 10. I want all of us to read together. So we just read from whatever version you've got, and I'll be reading from here. So we may start from verse 19. Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. Everybody read with me. A man was there by the name of Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector and was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but because he was short, he could not see over the crowd. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore fig tree to see him, since Jesus was coming that way. When Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must stay at your house today." So he came down at once and welcomed him gladly. All the people saw him and began to mutter, "He is going to be the guest of a sinner." But Zacchaeus stood up and said to the Lord, "Look, Lord, here and now I give half of my possessions to the poor. And if I have cheated anybody out of anything, I will pay back four times the amount." Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and save the lost." Amen, church. Now, what did we learn of Zacchaeus from the verse that we have just read? We learned that he was short. We learned that he was a tax collector. We learned that he was a thief and mean. We learned also that he was rich. You can see that bag of gold. He had a big family. He had many servants. He had a big house. But he was not happy. He heard about Jesus and went looking for him. Luke 19 verse 1 says, Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. A man was there by the name of Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector and was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but being short, he could not because of the crowd. So he ran ahead and climbed the sycamore fig tree to see him, since Jesus was coming that way. So where did Zacchaeus find Jesus? We read on the Jericho road. Now, on the Jericho road, that's where beggars would take home a lot of money, because they would go there and sit and beg. On the Jericho road, that's where traders would take home a lot of profit, because there was big business there. On the Jericho road, gossipers were there as well to find listeners. And on the Jericho road, the proud and rich, you know, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, wearing their pompous gowns, they would find some audience. On the Jericho road, the lonely would at least get some human noise around them. If you lived by yourself and you had nothing to do, you know, Jericho road was busy. You would go there, you'd get some human noise, and you'd feel like you're a human being. The Jericho road was a buzz of activities. And Jericho Road was popular. We know in America, Wall Street is popular, in New York. Those who've been to London, you know Oxford Street. And those who come from Zimbabwe, you know Mbare. And the First Street, they are so popular. So what type of audience was there on this Jericho Road? I'm sure Zacchaeus was not the only man. There were some short people there as well. And I'm sure that some people who were there were just happy to take along, not doing anything. And I'm sure there were also tall people in that crowd on the Jericho Road. But the crowd was so big, and not everyone, I'm sure, could see Jesus. So some people just came to pass time, and some people just came for the noise. There was a big crowd. I'm sure some came to shush the blind man, beggars like Bartholomew. We know on the Jericho Road, Jesus healed this blind man who shouted and said, "Son of David, save me." So some people were telling him, "Shut up, shut up." So some people came just for that on the Jericho Road. Some, they actually came to do business on Jericho Road. Some came to beg. Some came to socialize. Some were on their way from Jericho to Jerusalem. You know the story of the Good Samaritan. There was a man on the journey from Jerusalem to Jericho. So he obviously used that Jericho Road. Some came just to see, because they had nothing to do. Some came to just criticize. As we found out, they criticizing Jesus when he invited Zacchaeus. Say, "Oh, he's come to take sinners." Some came to grumble, because some were grumbling that he's a tax collector. Why is Jesus going there? Some came to shout, "Jesus of Nazareth is passing by." Because when Jesus was passing, people would be shouting, "Oh, Jesus of Nazareth is passing by." But they didn't even get saved themselves. And I'm sure there were some who didn't even know what was going on. But little Zacchaeus came to see Jesus. And Jesus saw him too. Can't we say hallelujah? And Jesus, when he saw Zacchaeus, he told him to come down quickly and told him to go and prepare a dinner. So when you look for Jesus, he will see you too. And it does not end there. When you see and look for Jesus, miracles happen. And when you look for Jesus, life gets a meaning. And when you look for Jesus, the soul gets a healing. And when we look for Jesus, families, communities, and nations are saved. Now look who's coming to dinner to Zacchaeus' house. That's Jesus. He went with Zacchaeus, and Jesus went with him. And Revelation 3, verse 20, it says, "Here I am. I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in and eat with that person, and they with me." You know, Zacchaeus realized that he was short and needed to climb a tree to see Jesus. So ask yourself, what are your shortcomings? Do you realize what is making you short? It may not be short in height, but you may be short spiritually. Are you realizing your shortcomings? You know, for Zacchaeus, money didn't bring him happiness and salvation. Sometimes we need to give our materialism, our idols. It may not be cash, maybe your iPhone, WhatsApp, Facebook, whatever, this social media. What is it that you have so much that's still not giving you happiness and salvation? Zacchaeus realized he was a sinner in need of grace. He did all he could to meet Jesus, including running ahead to get onto a tree and wait for Jesus to pass by. You know, I'm thinking Zacchaeus was an old man and he's short. And you know, when you're old, you can't run that fast. So I'm sure he had to run. Maybe there were better trees. A sycamore, a fig tree, as we know, is very slippery. And I'm sure because he was short, he probably didn't have time to get onto an easier tree. He had to run ahead, you know, to get into a fig tree, which was really difficult, and he was old. But he had to do it because he wanted to what? To see Jesus. So sometimes we have to get out of our comfort zones. You don't have to keep sitting where you are. Run if you have to run. Climb a sycamore tree, that is difficult, even if you have to, because Jesus is passing by. So Jesus did not only go to dinner at Zacchaeus' house, he brought more. So I'm telling you today that when you do a deal with Jesus, he gives you more than you bargained for. Jesus brought salvation to Zacchaeus' house. He brought salvation for his family. Salvation for Zacchaeus' servants. Salvation for Zacchaeus himself. Salvation for his children, his wife, and everything. So when you look for Jesus, he does not only come to have dinner with you. He will save your whole household. Zacchaeus, in turn, promised to pay back what he had stolen four times. It may not be four times for you, but when you have made a mistake, you can make amends with God according to what you have. God will honor that if you honor that as well. He promised to give to the poor. We can still do it. We can come to the soup kitchen. We can go to the hospitals, pray for others. There's so many ways we can help. We may not have the cash to give to the poor, but we are rich in spirit, and we can use spiritual gifts to pay back to God. And above all, he was saved and ready for heaven. Now ask yourself, when you come to church, or whenever you stand in the presence of the Lord, what are you really in for? Are you just following the crowds like people on the Jericho Road? Are you bored? Or is it because you've got nothing to do? Or are you coming to just watch others? Or are you just coming to criticize? Or just to see what others are doing? Or because your family comes to church? Or because there's no other option? Are we just here to grumble? Are we just here to gossip and murmur? Are we here to criticize? Are we here to socialize? So what are you taking home from here? Zacchaeus took Jesus home. Time is running out. Let us take Jesus home too. And let us tell others the good news. Zacchaeus gave up materialism and idols. So let us do that as well. You know what your idol is. You need to give it up if you want to see Jesus. Let us accept salvation whilst there is still time. And let us enlist our names in the book of life. Let us ask Jesus to save us from our sins and make us better people, fitted for heaven. Someday soon, we'll be home for that big, big, big dinner. When Jesus himself will be welcoming us to the, you know, welcome table. And will you be there, my friend, when the pearly gates shall open? May God bless his word.